transpiration. So when we talk about transpiration, it basically occurs only in plants. It is actually the loss of water or the loss of excess water from the leaves or the stem of a plant. Now this excess water is basically absorbed through evaporation. So evaporation is the process of the conversion of liquid to water vapors in the presence of external heat. And in the case of plants, that heat is basically coming from the sun. Now when there is transpiration, which is a removal of excess water, now how does water come inside the plant? It comes from the xylem vascular tissue. Now this xylem vascular tissue transports water and minerals from the roots to the other parts of the plant. Now when it transfers water and the minerals, it is actually in the upward direction. So this upward movement of the water and the minerals from the roots to other parts of the plant body, basically those other parts are the leaves, because leaves require water to prepare the food with the help of photosynthesis. Now when there is upward movement, this movement of the water particles or the water molecules is also unidirectional. That means it is only in one direction, that is in the upward direction. Now when we have discussed how the water comes inside the plant body and how the water goes outside the body with the help of transpiration, we can now discuss the various important functions of transpiration. So the first important function of transpiration is the movement or the release of excess water. So this excess water is removed or released with the help of evaporation from the surface of leaves or the surface of the stem. Now the second important function of the transpiration is in the temperature regulation. So whenever there is movement of the excess water or the release of excess water, there the excess temperature, or we can say the removal, leads to a cooling effect. Now when there is cooling effect in the plant, that means the temperature has decreased, or we can say the temperature has been regulated throughout the plant body. Now this temperature regulation helps in proper growth and development of the plant body. The third important function, of the transpiration is actually the movement or the transpiration pull. Now what is transpiration pull? Transpiration pull basically refers to the upward movement of the plant in the tall trees or the height or the trees with various or the trees with numerous height. Now when the tree is really very tall, it is very difficult for the xylem vessel to transfer the water to the utmost tip of that plant. So when it is unable to transfer that water, that transportation is done with the help of the transpiration pull. Now when the sun at the maximum height tries to absorb water, so as the sun tries to absorb water, the water molecules will start to rise in the stem. Now when they start to rise in the stem, that water can be absorbed by the molecules of the plant or the leaves or the stem of that plant at the topmost height. That is known as the transpiration pull. It is a most it is very beneficial for the trees which has maximum height. So these are the functions of the transpiration: to remove the excess water, to actually maintain the temperature regulation in the plant, and for the transpiration pull in very tall trees. So let us now discuss more on the concept on transpiration in plants. As we have discussed what is transpiration, we will now discuss what are the types of transpiration. So the most common type of transpiration is the stomatal transpiration. So stomatal transpiration, as the name suggests, stomatal means from stomata. So when there is transpiration or loss of water from the stomata, so basically stomata are these small pores on the leaves which help in the exchange of gases. Now when there is removal of water from these stomatas, it refers to the stomatal transpiration. And this type of transpiration is the maximum transpiration of the four different types of transpiration which we will discuss now. The second type of transpiration is the cuticular transpiration. Now cuticular comes from the word cuticle. So, cuticle is actually the waxy waterproof layer on the epidermis, or we can say the epidermis is the topmost layer of the leaf, and on that epidermis we have a waxy layer known as cuticle. Basically, this cuticle helps in the prevention of transpiration. So, when there is transpiration, which is actually very less from these cuticles or from the cells of these cuticles, it is known as the cuticular transpiration. Then the third we have lenticular transpiration. So when there is transpiration from the lenticles, so lenticles are small pores present on the leaves or the stem of the plant, it is known as the lenticular transpiration. It is also very similar to the cuticular transpiration, and both these types of transpirations occur in very small amount as compared to the stomatal transpiration. So the last type of transpiration is the bark transpiration. So basically bark is referred to the outermost covering on the stem present on the woody trees, and these types of bark usually shed away as the tree grows in, or as the plant grows in height. So as the plant grows, these bark or the outermost covering of the stem, especially of the woody plants, is removed, and from this bark, if there is transpiration, it is referred to as the bark transpiration. So till now we have discussed what is transpiration, that is the removal of the excess water from the surface of the leaves, and then we have discussed the various functions like the movement or the excess removal of water. Then we have discussed the temperature regulation in the plant, and in the end we have discussed it helps in the transpiration pull present in tall trees, for the beneficial for tall trees. And now we have discussed the four important types of transpiration. The maximum is the case of stomatal transpiration occurring from the stomata. Then we have cuticular transpiration occurring from the cuticle, which is a waxy layer over the leaves. So it is the minimum, we can say cuticular and lenticular are the minimum transpiration processes, but the maximum is the case in stomatal. The case of bark. Bark is only present in woody plants. So when there is transpiration on the bark, or because of the outermost covering of the stem, it is known as the bark transpiration. So this was the complete discussion on the concept of transpiration in plants. You can always refer to the video on the xylem, because xylem is an important concept which helps in transportation of water.